Quetzalcoatl Entertainment presents Quindon's Animation Extravaganza, Episode 161, Friends Day Out.
Time to shine, everything will be alright. Everyone's excited to see you come. Quindon's Animation Extravaganza. Lots to do, all we need now is you. Now it's time for this show to begin. Quindon's Animation Extravaganza. 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 Extravaganza.
Oh, hi! Welcome to Animation Land. As you can see, I've just started working on my script for Chapter 58 of Humans of Sentai Goranger. Well, seeing as I've now seen the May 6's true forms, I bet my fellow Powerpuffs ought to know about this. It's nice to know that while we were battling our way through the Black Cross Army, we were also saving Equestria without even knowing it. Come in!
Quindon-san!
Oh, hi, Miyako. What brings you here?
Have you seen the May 6 lately?
Oh, yes. I just saw them on Friday, in fact. Why do you ask?
Well, they told my friends and me about their past and how they became funnies in the first place.
Wow. Now we've all seen their true forms. Sounds like a plan.
Okay, I found the Powerpuffs and the May 6 are waiting for us in Prague.
You mean the arcade where we met Luna?
Exactly. Come on, let's go.
Yeah, Red Falcon, eat my shorts. Get him, Q. Those Freeza no match for the ultimate Powerpuff.
You the man, Quindon. Kick that alien ass.
I'm surprised that Quindon's able to breeze through Contra.
I know, right? It's like the hardest game in this entire arcade.
Guess the spread gun really helps.
Guys, have you even noticed this?
What is it?
Apparently a new title has arrived. It's called Brave Soldier Sailor Moon.
Wow, this must be based on our battle against the Dark Kingdom.
I can still remember when I first met Luna. I was completely shocked when I realized she could talk. She gave me a magical brooch to change my life forever.
We were already fighting the first Yoma by the time you arrived.
Over the next 12 weeks, four other Sailor Senshi joined us. Ami Mizuno, Rei Hino, Makoto Kino, and Minako Aino.
Kosaki eventually found out that she was the Moon Princess Serenity and that the other four Sailor Senshi were her bodyguards, the princesses of Mercury, Mars, Jupiter, and Venus, respectively. With all five Sailor Senshi on her side, we easily defeated the Dark Kingdom's Big Four, which were in reality Prince Endymion's bodyguards under the spell of Queen Beryl.
After they were freed, Queen Beryl took control of Prince Endymion himself, or rather, his modern-day reincarnation, Mamoru Chiba. Thank God we took care of that when we killed Queen Beryl.
During the final battle against Queen Metalia, we found out that Quindon was the reincarnation of the Sun Prince and used his special power, Solar Mass Destruction, in combination with Sailor Moon's power to disintegrate Metalia, ending the Dark Kingdom for good.
Yeah, good times. Anyway, what do you say we have Mario Brothers pizza and pasta for lunch?
We were all just thinking the same thing. Let's go!
Welcome to Mario Brothers pizza and pasta. How many will it be?
15, please.
Mamma mia!
Well, write these away, please.
Hey, Main 6, we could definitely use your help for something.
Like what?
My fellow Powerpuffs and I are currently on a mission to exterminate the criminal organization Crime, who want to turn Animation Land into a crime paradise.
Well, we can't have that, can we?
The organization we're helping for this mission, ISIS, has a Sentai team of their own. They are the Jackguard Dengeki Tai, and they have an awesome finishing move. It'll be just like old times. What do you say?
All right, you can rely on us whenever we're needed.
All right then, it's said. And thank you for spending some quality time with us. Be sure to stop by whenever crime attacks, okay? All right, see you later.
Bye-bye!
This episode was an original story created entirely for this show. Written by Quindon Cole, copyright 2019.
This program is a production of Quetzalcoatl Entertainment.
This is PBS, the Public Broadcasting Service.